Okay, so that's my first ride with the Forcefield XVR2. The model is a bit confusing, the naming. So that's the first time. I'm trying to get some splitter that I got inside me on inside the glove, so try to take it out because it's annoying while riding. Anyway, that's the first time. Now I had some flowy trail until I got here, so I'm using FXR jersey and pants. That's the Revo, so it's quite not restricting airflow, so it's very good. It's ventilated, and because of the good ventilation, the force field ventilation is also great, because you're getting like two mesh clothing on you. I bet that if I'll go just with the force field, I'll feel much more airflow, but then it's also prone to get torn by trees, branches and all that, so I prefer getting leaving it beneath the jersey. Let's hope that I got it out. I'm pretty sure that I didn't, but that's life. So anyway, that's how it looks like. As you can see, it's very, you can see the skin right beneath it, so it's very very ventilated, you got it. So that's it basically. So I'll try to do one lap, then give you my review regarding the force field. It's chest, back, shoulders and elbows protector, sea level 2, all of the parts, which is the only one that I know about. The downside is you don't have like a side rib support, rib protection, so that's the only downside to this one currently, protection wise. Not too much to get a glove out. Feeling a retarded kid. What the hell? Sorry, I didn't get this out. I'll skip forward. So you don't need to watch me fighting the glove. I'm taking it slow because two things. That's the first lap. So okay, three things. First lap, so it's a warm up, and also I saw some guy on a bike, mountain bike, riding in front of me, so I need to be careful. And the third one is the tree branches. Didn't ride here quite for a long time, so I don't know what changed. So sometimes tree branches are falling on the single track, and if I'll go too fast, then I won't be able to brake in time. Again, until now the force field feels okay. Don't feel it moving too much around. Here's the first branch, as you can see. Basically it's not moving at all, so it feels very secure on the body. That's the reason I took a medium small, so it will be tight and won't move around at all. I hate when my protection is moving around. I'm not concentrated. Sorry for the bad riding, didn't ride for quite a long time, and I'm trying to speak while riding and I'm not good at it at all, so as you can see. Bicycle, but as I can see right now, he's doing a greater pace than me. fast. Which is good, it's a good sign for good ventilation. Let me talk to the bicycle guy. כן, לא רוצה לעשות, בגלל זה אני לא רוצה זה, אז תן לי 10 שניות כדי שלא יהיה לך אבק בכלל, בסדר? Okay, so we lost the single track, that's the why I didn't see him. I thought it was a very fast guy, but maybe he is, but you cannot fight a dirt bike on a bicycle. Maybe you can. There are very fast downhill guys on bicycles. Never mind, stop talking. Talk also only on the protection. Because last time I was riding with very low crashed back in front and it was horrible. So my bike was all over the place. Right now I'm with 13 front and I think 11 back, or 10, something like that. It feels very, very good. Back tires is a Dunlop MX53 and the front is a Dunlop D909, which is an enduro tire. I got this recommendation from a friend and it turns out very, very good. Handling is good, traction is good, stability, everything. So I really like this combination. As you can see, loyal guy or something like that, but I really like the bike after all the modification I did. So I think it is not race ready at all, even the carb version, because the Mikuni carburetor was the worst thing ever. Fault neutral. So leaves are not good for traction at all. So they're not helping me doing those turns. Somewhere in the past that if you are working out like too much of dumbbells and working out on your arms, then once you will go on the bike you can get far more worse arm pump, because the muscles thinks like you're working out, so it trying to pump and give you more, but then it, no, it sticks the blood when doing endurance. So maybe that's good for weights, but not for endurance kind of sport. So I hope that you can hear me at all. If not, that's a bummer, because I'm talking a lot. Riding with this arm pump. It was a while since the last time I had such a bad arm pump. And the protection. Just for the experiment, I want to take out the jersey and see the differences. Which is very nice. Sorry for the slow pace, guys. I'm getting arm pump, so I don't want to injure and do some mistakes. Oh, the opposite. Do some mistakes and then get injured. I need to ride more. until now nothing moved, which is good. Feels very, very good. The ventilation for the protection itself is more stricter, of course, than the mesh fabric, but it's still good. So you're sweating a bit in the protection area on the elbows. I don't feel it on the back or the chest too much, just on the elbows. So, but nothing major. Like, it's not annoying or something like that. And of course, you're just, when you're riding, you're sweating no matter what. So if you are riding and you don't want to sweat, just stop riding. But of course, heat management is very good with this setup, so you need a good ventilated jersey to take advantage of the mesh fabric of the Forcefield shirt, so vest, maybe we need to call it. Oh, here I can feel the air blowing through, which is very, very nice. Very good feeling. I have the other protection of Forcefield, which offers also ribs protection, and this for the side of the ribs, and this one doesn't offer it, but you need to compromise for more convenient stuff, you know. So there are also a trade-off. So here you are getting more of a natural feel when you are riding. You are not feeling restricted at all. Everything is in place. Very good ventilation. What else? It's not bulky. But then on the other one that I have, which is the K, what is the name? EXK. So on the EKX or EXK, EKX maybe. No, EKX. So on that one, which I'll do a review next time, you are getting more of back protection, so it's covering more of your back, and you are getting tailbone protection, and also you are getting elbows, ribs protection, which is good. But then I don't want to bother them. Shnia achat, slicha. So you are getting very good ribs protection, but then it's more heavy, it's heavier, and the airflow is a bit worse. So it's a trade-off. I see place for both of them. That's why I bought both of them. I really believe in Forcefield. They're having very good stuff on their inventory. And just having all the protection parts, sea level 2, it's very, very nice, you know? I don't see any protection gear for dirt bikes that offers elbows and shoulders sea level 2. All of them are sea level 1, and sea level 1, it's okay, but you are getting the bruises and some soreness after a fall, a very hard fall. You know what, not even very hard fall. But then with the sea level 2, I had multiple accidents, like crashes and all that, with the dirt bike, and also always the elbow protection saved me, and I didn't feel anything. One time when I was very skinny, the previous model of Forcefield that I had didn't have straps for the elbow, so it just slipped off from my elbow while crashing, and then I got bruised, but it got some of the impact, which is good. but then it didn't help entirely protecting my elbow. But with the new protection, they have straps, so it's very, very nice. And now tree branch. Can I move it? I think I can. Maybe next time. Chest protection, like it feels like it's not it's intact, but when you're just looking at the jersey, the protection, let's try this one. Ah, that was lame. I want to try again, sorry. So when I just put it on, it felt very, very safe, so it won't move anywhere, and it did does its job, and it's not moving at all. So I'm very confident that it will protect me when needed, and I hope it wouldn't be put into test in reality. So it will be. I wish that I knew how to do how it calls pivot point, pivot turn. Wasn't that high, it was like a far jumping, far shoot, not high, which is, it's good. So this one was a very nice lap. I hope you enjoyed it. Commentary, let me know if you want me to continue speaking while riding, if you cannot hear me at all. I'm not sure about it. What a mess. Look what people are doing in leaving all the mess and trash behind them. I don't get it. Okay, I need to shoot a review in Hebrew, and I need some light, so thank you for watching, guys. Bye bye.